I'm going to show you how you can subclass structs. As you know, you cannot subclass structs, so you're wondering, how can you do that? I'll show you. So in Swift, you have to know structs are awesome. I try to use them as much as possible, everywhere as possible. Start with structs first and only fall back to use classes if needed. Why? Well, as you've seen in the first talk, and as you may know, structs are value semantic, which means your code is more predictable, it's easier to reason with. Structs are also super fast compared to classes. Actually, in Swift 1.0, it was up to 40 times faster than classes. And in Swift 2.0, with whole module optimization, I found some benchmarks on the internet, so it must be true, claiming even faster results. Another thing I like with structs is automatic initializers, which means less code for you to write. For instance, imagine you have this struct, so a post, you know, like a Facebook post with a few fields. Well, you just have to declare your fields, and then you can immediately instantiate a post object without declaring your initializer, and which means every time you rename a variable, you add, remove, reorder variables, the initializer is created for you. It's a nice thing to have. So the problem with that is you cannot subclass. If you want to subclass, well, you use classes, right? So it's too bad, because sometimes all your models are made with structs, and you really don't want to have to go back to structs. So let's take a follow-up with this post example. Currently, we have a text post. And imagine you want to add image posts and video posts. So a bad way to do it would be just to add more fields like that. Of course, it is bad because, as you can tell, you bloat your object for nothing. You add fields that most of the time are going to be nil. Only one of them or one of the related ones are going to be nil. You lose the semantic because, of course, a post in this case is either text or video or image, so which means one, for instance, the two video fields are going to have a value and all the other ones are going to be nil, and it's something that you don't capture with this model. And a bad thing also with this model is that, for instance, the text field is now an optional because it's only going to hold a value when it's a text post and the other time it's going to be nil. So even if you know that you have a text post, you are always going to have to unwrap your optional, which is a lot of code and tedious. So what are the solutions? Well, one of them is to use classes, you know, and subclasses, but that's what we want to avoid. Why not protocols then? Because, as you know, Swift is a protocol-oriented programming language, so maybe we can add there something to do with protocols. Here, actually, no, because protocol allow you to add method to a struct. It allows you to add method implementations, computed properties, but not really stored properties, unless you use Objective-C associated objects hacks, but even there, you need a class at the root. So the solution is to use enums. Enums in Swift are super powerful. Here you have an enum that would say you have three types of posts, right? And you can add associated values. So each of these states have the few fields that you would have in your subclass. So the post, which initially looks like that, would look now just holding this enum, and the enum will hold the different values for the different subclasses cases. So here you can see an example of how to create a text post, image post, and video post. And it's great, it's semantic, expressive, and you can switch on them, on the type, with an exhaustive switch. So that's a great way to subclass structs. I hope you liked it. Thank you.